Alright, now time for the Wii and GameCube games. Again, I'm putting them together because I play GameCube games on the Wii, so there you go. I'm actually going to show one thing off, though, before I actually start this. This SD card actually holds Project M. This is how I play Project M. Pretty much what it is, it's a fan mod that pretty much makes the game Super Smash Bros. Brawl pretty much have melee physics. For those of you that don't know, all two of you that are watching this, if you're even watching this, pretty much what it is that Super Smash Bros. Melee, a game for the GameCube, is a fighting game where a bunch of Nintendo game characters beat the shit out of each other, and you know, you choose one, and just you get the point. It's a fighting game. But it was much faster than the other games in the series, and had more advanced physics, and because of it, it actually had a lot of glitches that, you know, that led to a lot of advanced techniques that a lot of competitive players use, and Brawl took those things out and slowed down the gameplay a bit. People didn't like this, so people made Project M to pretty much make Brawl play like Melee, so that's pretty much what it is. You can look it up for more information. I can link you to the website below, so there you go. Check it out, it's a cool mod. The current version right now is 3.5, and it's actually a lot of fun, so check it out when you can. Anyway, just wanted to point that out, give a little shout out to them. Not like they need it, because they're much more popular than I am. Heck, I'm small fry on YouTube, so I only have 29 subscribers. Not that I'm not grateful for your subscriptions, but you know, still. Just thought I'd share that. Anyways, speaking of Super Smash Bros. Brawl, here it is! This was my favorite Super Smash Bros. Game, but I think Wii U is just a lot better in terms of gameplay, so. But this is still a really fun game. If you have a Wii, you need to get this, alright? Just get it. You're missing out. Hell, even if you don't like Brawl physics, you can still download Project M like I just showed you. So, there you go. I personally prefer Brawl over Melee, though, because I prefer the game being a little slowed down. Mainly because I can time my movements a bit better. Melee, one of the problems I had with Melee is that sometimes my moves don't work the way they should because the game is so much faster. And it doesn't happen with any other game though. It doesn't happen with Brawl. It doesn't happen with the N64 game because those are much slower than Melee. So I can only see it as Melee's gameplay physics. Like, sometimes I do a certain move, like say I'm doing the sidestep, but it doesn't do anything. The shield activates, but that's all it does. I'm still standing in place. So I look like a complete moron, just tapping the shield button, just waiting for the sidestep to finally work. It doesn't happen much for me in Brawl. It doesn't happen any time in Brawl. The N64, it did happen to me a little bit, but I can mostly blame that on just poor controls, I guess. But for Melee, it happened a lot, like, especially in Melee, and I can only see that as Melee's physics kind of fucking me over. That's just personally what I think. I'm not gonna say Melee's a bad game. Melee's a fantastic game, and you should get both games. Just want to point that out there before anyone asks. I know if anyone comes onto this video, and if anyone, like, legitimately watches the entire thing, they're gonna be asking which one I prefer, so I might as well set the record straight now. Just get it over with. Back to the collection. Sonic Heroes! I already gave you my opinions on Heroes. You might have saw I had the PS2 version of Heroes! Now you know why I got the GameCube version. If you don't, look it up. I'm not going to explain it here. Let's just say the GameCube game is better. It's more stable, I should say. PS2 version is a lot glitchier and with a piss poor frame rate. Look it up. Just look it up. Pokemon the movie. Wait a minute. This isn't a video game. Well, it actually, since I lost the movie a long time ago, I have a case for Sonic Adventure 2. If I can get it on screen. Yeah, there we go. Sonic Adventure 2. Battle. GameCube version. I do have the HD version. The HD version is better in terms of multiplayer because it has the alternate costumes unlocked from the get-go. And the GameCube version is better, has a better Chao Garden. Other than that, they're mostly the exact same game. So, get either or. The HD version has widescreen support, so there you go. Just get that version if you really want widescreen support. And Sonic Adventure 2 is one of those games that I feel is actually... It's very subjective whether it's good or not, because it really all depends on if you like the gameplay styles. I may not be a huge fan of the treasure hunting, but I do like the shooting levels and the running levels. I like the chowder, and I like the multiplayer, I like the missions. So, you know, I really like Sonic Adventure 2. I think it's one of those underrated Sonic games. So, definitely not the best Sonic game, though. I wouldn't say that. Nor the best 3D Sonic game. And Sonic Zero Gravity. Sonic Riders, Zero Gravity, the sequel to Riders. I actually do like this game. I don't know why people hate it so much. Like, people say it's way too complex for its own good. This game is easy. I beat this game. In fact, alright, fun fact, this was the only Riders game I did beat. I didn't bother beating Free Riders, and I think you guys know why, but Sonic Riders, I didn't beat it because it was way too hard for me. Even nowadays, when I actually know what I'm doing, the AI kicks my ass every single time on story mode. Doesn't kick my ass anywhere else. I'm on the level, the desert level, in the Babylon story. You know, the final story, with Jet the Hawk. Eclipse Cannon, I believe it's called. That's the level I'm stuck on. I don't know, every time I come close, someone passes me, like that. It's like Mario Kart Wii's AI. But, this one's easy. You know, the races are pretty easy in story mode, and it's actually pretty fun. I like the way the tracks are designed, and I like the zero gravity gimmick. I don't know why people hate it. So, whatever, don't listen to the critics. If you want a decent racing game, Sonic Riders Zero Gravity is pretty good. Star Wars The Clone Wars Lightsaber Duels, aka Cash Grab the video game. It's kind of fun. Sonic and the Black Knight. I don't like the game very much. I think you guys know why I don't like Sonic and the Black Knight. SpongeBob SquarePants movie. The video game. This is actually a video game. Only this actually is a PS2 game. So why do I have it? Why do I have this with the Wii section? Well, before, it's not actually that. It's come on, Sonic Unleashed for the Wii. The Wii version's all right. Sonic Unleashed for the Wii is all right. I never beat Unleashed both versions. I have both versions. I probably could if I tried, but I don't feel like it. I think it's because I stopped playing it because I started playing Generations and Colors, and those were just so much better. But I had the Wii version first for Unleashed, and it was alright. And this is Sonic Adventure DX. Honestly, I would recommend getting the HD port for this one. With Sonic Adventure 2, it doesn't really matter, but with Sonic Adventure 1, it does. If you want to get a good version of Sonic Adventure 1, get the HD version. Don't get this version. This version has massive, massive slowdown issues. And I don't know if it's my disc or what, but this thing chugs at points. You know, get the HD version. It's a lot more... The slowdown, it doesn't slow down nearly as much. In fact, I don't think it slows down really at all. Except for in the Chao Garden. It slows down a bit in the Chao Garden. Which, oddly enough, this version of the game, the GameCube version, doesn't slow down at all in the Chao Garden. It's weird. But honestly, I don't really care for the Chao Garden adventure, do you want the Chao Garden to slow down, or do you want the game to slow down, depending on which version? Just choose the HD version, because, trust me, the Chao Garden isn't even worth your time in this game. Sonic Adventure 2's Chao Garden is so much better. Just get the HD port, it doesn't slow down nearly as much. Sonic and the Secret Rings. Do I even need to say why I don't like this game? You just tilt the remote like this. It's really annoying and... Needless to say, it wasn't a good starting point for the Sonic games on the Wii. I'm just gonna leave it at that. I think you guys know why I don't like the game. I think everyone knows why people don't like... I think everyone knows why people don't like the game. So I just leave it at that. Wii Play. Believe it or not, I actually like this game. It's not the best game ever, but it's okay for a tech demo. I actually remember having a lot of fun with this game. I don't know why people hate it so much. Like, people say it's really boring. I found the game's kind of fun. It's kind of like Mario Party, only, you know, without the board game. So, it was okay. Superstars Tennis. Sega Superstars Tennis. I'm not really a tennis guy, nor am I a tennis game player thing. I don't play tennis games. I don't even play Mario Tennis. But Sega Superstars Tennis is okay, I guess. I don't know. I can't really compare it to any other tennis games. I never played Mario Tennis either, so, you know. For what it is, it's okay. Star Wars The Force Unleashed for the Wii. This is my favorite version of the game. Mainly because it has more levels, it has multiplayer, which is actually worth a damn, unlike Force Unleashed 2, and it's actually rather fun. The motion controls work pretty well, they don't hinder my experience at all. And even if you don't like them, you can just spam Force Lightning everywhere, so there you go. Especially when it's fully upgraded. But Force Unleashed I really liked. I really like the HD version too, but to me the Wii version just has more going for it. The HD version is still good though. It does have better graphics than the Wii version. The Wii version, I will admit, doesn't really look good for Wii standards. It looks like a PS2 game, because it is a PS2 game. Oh, look at that, the sequel. AKA Cash Grab the video game. Even bigger than any other cash grab too, because this is a sequel to a game that many people were split on. Force Unleashed was very split among the community, but enough people liked it, so it got a sequel. And of course, it's a cash grab. The story is barely there. In fact, there is no story. There's nothing to the story at all. It's only 3 hours long. It's super, super short. When compared to the first one was at least like 8 to 11 hours on first time playthrough. This one, it took me almost a day to beat it. And that's not because I have no life. There's only 4 levels in the entire game. Like 4 or 5 levels, that's it. Oh sure, levels can be really long at points, and that can get really annoying, and they can overstay their welcome, and that can be really annoying, but still, overall, Force Unleashed 2 is really, really, really boring. And all you're beating up is stormtroopers, and that's really boring too. I will say this. The Wii version is the better version of the two, because the gameplay is a bit faster, but it also is worse in some respects, because, mostly because there's, what is it, the levels go on even longer than the HD version, and that is so annoying. But at the very least, there are some good points about it. For one thing, the first couple of levels, the first 2 levels, the second level in particular, is much easier and much shorter than the HD version. I thought the HD version was really, really annoying, the second level, because it went on for way too freaking long. You spent way too long in Kato, I forget what the planet is called, Kato Minoy or something like that. It's the level with the giant Rancor monster that you face. That, you know, the boss fight isn't nearly as bad either, because the boss fight overstays his welcome too, for some reason, in the HD version. So for everything it gets right, it also gets something wrong. The multiplayer is also kind of disappointing. I never played the multiplayer, actually, because I didn't have anyone to play with, but from what I see, it's just a Smash Brothers clone. Like, I'm not even joking, it's a Smash Brothers clone. And there were points at the end of the game where I just wanted to stop playing. There are also some enemies that are just downright frustrating in the game. So, you know, in some ways it's better than the HD version, and in some ways it's worse. So, Sonic Colors. This is a fantastic Sonic game. I really do think it is a fantastic Sonic game. The Wisps are a lot of fun to use, and, you know, the levels are really fun. One of my favorite levels in Sonic history is actually Aquarium Park, and it's in Sonic Colors. So, Sonic Colors is a fantastic game. Just, you know, it really is just a great game. I'd recommend it. Even people who don't like Sonic will like it. Anyway, Soul Calibur 2. This is my favorite Soul Calibur game. Not that the others are bad. Maybe Soul Calibur 3, because of that memory card bug, but Soul Calibur 2 is actually really fun. This is my favorite of the Soul Calibur series. It's a really good fighting game, has a lot of content. It has a lot of my favorite modes in the series, which they took out in the sequels for some random reason. I don't know why they took out a lot of the stuff that made Soul Calibur 2 great, but they did. And Soul Calibur 2 also has... It has tons of stuff that the other games don't, you know? It has, you know, it has alternate weapons, which from what I hear, Soul Calibur 5 doesn't have. It has, even though I never played Soul Calibur 5, but I heard it doesn't have the alternate weapons. It also has Link, which I know Link is Legend of Zelda, so they can't bring him back, but Link was one of my favorite characters to use in Soul Calibur 2. And he's my favorite third-party character that they put in the series so far. At the same time, it also has a couple of modes that I actually like. One mode in particular is the Team Battle Arcade and the Team Battle Versus. Pretty much what it is that you pick three or more characters, and your opponent picks three or more characters, and you beat, and then you fight until all the characters are pretty much dead. You beat the opponent. It goes down like a regular match. But here's how it works. Let's say I pick three characters, Nightmare, Link, and Maxi. I pick those three, and my opponent picks Nightmare, Sophitia, and Taki. Let's say those are the three characters everyone picks. If he knocks out my Nightmare, then I switch to Link during the next round. That's pretty much how it works. And it's a really, really fun mode, and one of my personal favorites. Just such a shame that they took it out, though. Mario Kart Wii! I'm not gonna do that anymore. I'm not gonna do that. That's just gonna annoy people. Mario Kart Wii. Not my favorite Mario Kart game, mainly because of the AI and some of the track designs are not very good. Rainbow Road! Mario Kart Wii, it's not a terrible game, it's just very flawed. Personally, my favorite is actually Mario Kart 8. We'll get to that in a moment. Super Smash Bros. Melee, I already said I like Brawl better, but there are some things that Melee has that Brawl doesn't. It's a fantastic game, I'd still recommend getting it. I might as well show these two games off since they're tech demos. Wii Sports, it's a fun tech demo, that's all it is. Link's Crossbow Training, I just got it because it was really cheap. I don't know why I got it. Alright, Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games. I didn't like this game very much. I thought some of the games were kind of poorly handled. And at the same time, the motion controls didn't really work very well. Which is a shame, because I actually prefer motion controls for party games like this than normal controls, but sadly, yeah. Sonic Gems Collection. Inappropriately named title, since out of the three games that are advertised in this, only one of them is actually sort of a gem. And that's Sonic the Fighters. No, I'm just joking. It's actually Sonic CD. Even though the original version of Sonic CD I'm not a huge fan of, when I talk about how good Sonic CD is, I'm more or less talking about the HD port, even though it's not actually HD. But, you know, the PS3 and 360 port. That is a great version of Sonic CD. But Sonic Gems Collection overall is an okay compilation. It's good if you want some obscure Sonic games, like Sonic R, and Sonic CD, and Sonic the Fighters. The Sonic the Fighters actually has an HD port now, which I'd recommend getting because it's just so much better. And LEGO Indiana Jones 2. It's a LEGO game, though actually probably my least favorite. The design and setup of the game isn't really very good, and the story doesn't follow the movies, unlike the first game, which kind of sucks, because I actually like that aspect of the LEGO games. So, oh well, and not my favorite LEGO game. Anyway, with that said, I know it just cut, I'm sorry, my camera does that after 20 minutes. With that said, that's about it for the Wii games. Let's move on to the next couple of games, which are the PS3 and 360 games. I'm going to be doing them both, because why not, again. They were like the main competitors of the 7th generation, so I'm going to do both HD consoles and both their games. So, that said, see you then.